please, my computer here can't read my slides, so I'll just be working blind a little bit here, so excuse me. We've heard quite a bit of talk about energy consumption, how much the average house uses. Gary mentioned 16 kilowatt hours per day. When you get your bill each 2 months, that's all you really know about the energy consumption in your house. The average each day for the last 2 months. If you want to start getting a little bit more information on that, what can you do? That's what we're talking about with meter logging or trying to track your energy consumption in a little bit more detail. What's the first and easiest thing you can do to get more information on your energy use? Well, you don't need any gadgets, you don't need any money, you don't need spending money. You've got a meter, exactly the same meter that the Synergy or Western Power comes and reads. You don't have to wait 2 months for them to read it. If you get the trick and the knack, it doesn't take long to read it, you can go and read your meter anytime you like. One of the most important first things I recommend to most people, I think Gary mentioned 50% of the people here don't have solar yet. If you're thinking about getting solar, don't use that 16 kilowatt hours a day that might say on your bill, because what the electricity you use at night, obviously, is irrelevant. You don't, it's no use to your solar panel. So one of the best things you can do when you're thinking about getting solar panels, read your meter in the morning, 8 o'clock when you're on your way to work, read it again when you come home, 5, 6 o'clock at night, and read it for a few days and work out, is it 10 units in the day and 6 at night? Or is it 6 in the day and 10 at night? That's very important information to give to your potential supplier of solar panels. Because whatever you use at night, apart from what Gary was saying of trying to shift stuff more into the daytime, of course, which you can try and do, but that's one of the most important things you can do. Just read your own meter. That's the simplest form of meter logging you can do. I've got a bag full, a little magic bag here full of gadgets now, electronic engineers, so I'm all into gadgets. If you're trying to do more, get more information on the energy consumption in your house, this is the one of the easiest ways you can do. An individual appliance, it's not to do with your whole meter logging, your whole house, how much energy is being used. If you want to track the energy use, say, of your fridge, how much energy does your fridge use? A little meter like this, you can see it's got a piggyback plug here. Plug this into the wall, plug the appliance in. This will light up, it'll tell you how much power it's using at any one time, and over time, over a couple of days, tell you how many units that individual appliance is using. So energy auditing, this is what the sort of thing, like Travis mentioned, I do. Put lots of these around houses, schools, that sort of thing, and try and build up a picture of what's using the energy in the house. And then, of course, once you know that, that's the area, the ones that are using the most, is the area to try and attack. This, excuse me, but this is all that's going to have to be dragged out in bits and pieces. This is a professional $300 gadget, which I use most of the time. You can go and buy $30 gadgets online, $25 at Bunnings, not as accurate, but for most of what you need to know, you can get that sort of thing pretty cheap and easy to use. In fact, a lot of the time now, a lot of the councils in WA are starting to put these in their libraries. But at least half the councils I've been to in WA, you can just go to the library and say, I want to borrow the energy saver kit, and it'll have one of these in. Just borrow it, just like borrowing a book for a few weeks, do your little checks and then send it back. It doesn't even cost you anything. Second option, going a little bit further, now going back to sort of trying to track, say, the energy use of the whole house, rather than going out and reading the meter all the time, a couple of other options you have is to get a gadget like this. This is $65 online, used to be about $100, and now that's about $65, $70. This is a sensor unit that sits inside the meter box. This little device here is a light sensor. If you have a digital meter, which is sort of getting to around 30-40% of the houses in Perth now do, there'll be a little light flashing, a little LED flashing on the meter box, on the power meter. This can count those flashes, calculates how much power you're using in the house at that time, transmits it inside your house to this little display unit, and this shows you the power use in the house right at that time, and how many units you've used that day, or that week, or that month. It's got all those sort of options on it. So a very cheap and easy device for keeping an eye without having to run backwards and forwards to the meter to do that tracking of what's happening. So you can read this, if it suddenly jumps up to 2 kilowatts and it's winter, have those kids put the heater on in the bedroom again with the door shut? This thing can tell you that sort of thing. It might be quite a handy little appliance. And there are lots of options, other options for doing that sort of thing. The problem with this is it only works with a digital meter. Some people call them smart meters, but it's basically a digital meter with a flashing LED. If you don't have that type of meter, if you're still on the old-fashioned dial type meter, moving dials, you have to go up a little bit further in sophistication to a similar device. This sits in your meter box, has a little wireless transmitter, sends the same signals into your house to tell you how much power you're using, but it has to be installed by an electrician. Instead of that little light, you have to get behind the power board. An electrician will clamp this as a it's called a current meter, current transformer, sorry. It'll clamp it around the wires on the supply to your house. That measures how much current is flowing through the wires, works out how much power you're using, and as I said, sends it inside the house, and same sort of thing. You have a display unit inside the house that can show you instantaneously. And it's sort of more of a habit type thing to try and get people used to looking at it, keeping an eye on it. Oh, we're using a lot more today, what's going on? Oh, we've got the air conditioner on, that's right, we're using a lot more energy. This one has a little bit more sophistication. You're sort of getting up to like the $150 mark of buying an appliance like this. Plus, of course, paying the electrician $100, $150 for that sort of... It's only like a 10-minute job for the electrician to install. It's very easy. Opens the box, clamps the transducers around, and shuts the box up again. So is that a question?
So does every calibration forward to put a dollar figure in straight away to... But people aren't very good at maths, but they say basically you're burning $50 a day. Can you put a dollar figure? Can you put a cost per unit energy in there and actually...
Oh yeah, yeah. These are all programmable because most of them have lots of different energy ways of displaying the information. You push the button to say, I don't want to see how many units I'm using. I want to see how many dollars it's costing me per hour or how much the electricity costs me. You can program them all for how many cents per unit it costs. Even time of use, even if you're on variable time. Some of them have 3-4 different zones that you can put in. What time of day does my electricity cost me? And it'll do all those calculations inside the engine board. This one goes up also a little bit more in sophistication in that it's got a computer connection on it. This is a USB connection, goes into here. You can connect this into your computer as well, so you don't even have to keep coming and looking at it all the time. Those charts that Travis was showing, which I would have been showing now if I had my slides working, are showing at every hour of the day. What does it look like? What does our profile look like? And you can keep that sort of information in your computer. A lot of them connect directly to the internet. And it all goes up into a website. You pull your phone out and you impress all your friends by saying, oh, look, that's how much power we used yesterday. All the little charts and that are all available on your phone. Huge variety of this sort of appliance on the internet. It just depends how far you want to go in terms of sophistication. This is one of the simplest ones. Comes with absolutely horrendously bad software for looking at it on your computer. It's not very good at all. But the more sophisticated ones, if you go and investigate that sort of thing, there are some really nice ones. I see people now who show it off to me when I go and order it on their house. They've got solar panels already. They pull out their phone and they say, oh yeah, we're generating 3 kilowatts at the moment. Oh, that's great. I wonder why I'm there in their house. But another option I should have mentioned with this device in particular is that one comes with an option of little extra plug packs. It comes with 3 of these little plug packs devices, which are individual appliance monitors. So as well as that being monitoring how much electricity the whole house is using, you can plug 3 of these into 3 individual appliances around the house, and that you can buy extras because that will handle 10 of these in any one house. And then it will also tell you how much each of those individual appliances was running. So you can connect one of these into your kid's computer and tell them at the end of every day, every week, oh, I see your computer used this many units last week. How much did the fridge use? All those sort of things. So that's quite a nice little feature of that one, is these individual appliance power meters as well. Again, these are all just wireless. That just transmits wirelessly back into that same unit around the Okay, jumping on quickly again, my favourite appliance which I use most often in my work, they're sort of the sort of appliances for people to use individually. This is my data logger that I use all the time in my work. That data that Travis was showing you for a whole, I think it was like 5 or 6 days of power use at time of day. This is a little gadget which is a general purpose data logger. It counts pulses. Anything you connect into these 2 terminals here that connects and disconnects an electrical signal, this will count it and record the time. About $110 to buy that. I put this on people's houses. Now I've got my own little sensor to, again, to connect to the meter to see how much power it's using. And I make it measure every minute. I usually set it up for 1 minute intervals. And so I come back a week later, I download the information from this into my computer, those same charts that Travis was showing. I can say how much power was your house using every single minute for the whole day for 2 weeks. And we can talk about it then in terms of what was going on at 3 o'clock here, 4 o'clock here. And we can talk about it in terms of the house and get a lot more information. The best chart, which I was sort of hoping to show you here, I had was from a house where from two consecutive days, we knew they used about 18 units a day. One day they used 15, the next was 35 units. And this has just happened coincidentally. What happened? The one big thing, and it was really good to show it to them because it made a great difference. The first day when they used about 15 units, it was 27 degrees, the maximum temperature, no air conditioning all day long. The next day was 35 degrees maximum, and this is a mum home with her kids. And I could see that the husband was quite interested in this. Oh look, you turned the air conditioner on at 11 o'clock. And the air conditioner ran all afternoon until the, well, it seemed to turn off about 5:30. Is that when you come home from work? Oh, it is, yeah. It's interesting. So the husband, and I have to be careful how you sort of present this sort of information. But that, it really made it very, very clear to them, two consecutive days, 15 units extra used by the air conditioner during that afternoon period. That was the only difference in the two charts for the two different days. And a great bit of information for those people. Okay. And if anybody wants to talk more about these, I'll be staying all afternoon, so please contact me.
Thank you.